Hi, I'm Sannie, and today I'm going to be talking about my journey with foreign language films. So I started watching foreign TV shows when I was a kid. There was this channel called Cartoon Network that used to air Japanese anime, and I used to watch Sailor Moon and Dragon Ball Z, and when I got to high school, I started watching Naruto. And it's really interesting because although Jamaica is so far away from Japan, there's always a group of kids in each class that is obsessed with Japanese anime. So I went up to a group of these kids and I was like, "Hey guys, I watch Naruto too." And they started laughing and chuckling. And I was like, "What?" And they were like, "You watch the dub version, don't you?" And I was like, "How do you know that?" And they're like, "Because it's pronounced Naruto, not Naruto." So from then on, I decided I would watch all foreign shows in their original audio with English subtitles. I'm really happy about it because this opened the door to so many movies and TV shows that I would just not have access to if I was relying on dubbed shows. One of the things I found interesting about Japanese horror films is that they're a lot scarier than American horror films because they kind of let the tension build slowly. And they don't really rely on scare tactics or blood and gore. And I realized a few American horror movies were actually adapted from Japanese movies. For example, The Ring and The Grudge. From there, I started watching Korean dramas and movies. And one of my favorite Korean movies is actually a zombie movie called A Train to Busan. It's so good. But my problem with Korean shows is that they can be so sad. Like, American movies usually have happy endings, and I kind of got used to it. But with Korean shows, not really. And it's just really hard to get over sometimes. But I'm enjoying my journey with foreign shows so far, and I'm looking forward to watching more foreign films in different languages from different countries.